Hello friends, welcome to my videos. So in this video I'm going to show you how you can submit your skill assessment application with Australian Computer Society for your skill migration to Australia. So before I proceed further, if you have not already subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe, because I regularly upload videos. And if you have any concern, any question, anything that you want to ask, feel free to ask. And if you have not already subscribed to my channel, go ahead and subscribe. Alright guys, so let's proceed. So we know that ACS, Australian Computer Society, is the assessment authority for ICT occupations when it comes to your Australia migration. So for various kinds of visas like 189, 190, 489 and many other, you need this assessment. So I'm going to show you how you can file this online application with them yourself. I've already published a video about the documents required, so I'm going to put the link in the description field. If you have not already watched, watch that first so that you get the idea about what documents you need. Alright guys, so I have opened this migration skill assessment area of ACS. So here I see the link online applications. Click on it. So the first thing is, like, they have also given, like, first review the guidelines, then prepare your documents. Once everything is ready, you can go ahead and file your application. I have covered these guidelines over there. And one important piece is dates here at DDMM YYYY. So this is the format that is followed in Australia, India and some countries. So if you are from a country like Canada, US, where we put month first, then be careful. This is the format of dates here. Alright guys, so let's proceed. So click on apply now. So I assume this is the first time you are applying for an application. So you have not applied before. So the first question is, do you have an existing ACS account or have you previously started an application? Say no. Next is to submit what kind of application. So we are going for skilled migration. So I'm going to select skills. Next is to select the ANZSCO code. So I assume, let's say we are filing for an analyst programmer. If you need any more information about these, you can just find it out over here. Click on continue. Now it's going to ask you the personal details. So I created an email address just before this video to make sure that I have. You don't have to contact me on this email address because I'm not going to monitor it. Yeah, they also check the availability if you have registered with this or not. Alright, so here comes your personal details. So let's consider a name, John Smith. Preferred first name, let's say John. Gender, let's say you are male. Date of birth, see they have given the format. Let's say you were born on 1st Jan 1995. Okay, the next field is country of birth, where you are going to select the country where you were born. So I select India, whatever is your case, and country of residence, that means in which country you are currently living. So I assume this guy John is in India, so India. Now passport number or birth certificate, so you need to upload either of these documents to establish your date of birth. So that I covered only that I already covered in the documentation section. So suppose you are uploading your passport, so click on browse files and do it. So I uploaded the document. Now the address, current residential address as well as contact details. Let me create a virtual address, one new Delhi street. New Delhi, I mean city, country, India, state, okay, postal code. I don't know any postal code of Delhi, so I just put this mobile number. Priority request. If you want priority request, click yes, then you need to select a reason, and also there will be fee.
But I assume you don't need, so I go for no, save and continue. Next comes is probably the most important section where you need to add your qualifications and your employment and attach relevant documents. So they have given the guidelines and I have already covered in the documentation video about what you need to. So in this, I'm just going to fill the form. So I assume this guy, John Smith, has completed a degree of 4 years, let's say from 2010 to 2014. So let's go for that. Let's say he did in 2010. And it was completed on 1st March 2010. Name. So suppose he did from Delhi University and he did a Bachelor's of Technology. The duration of the course, let's say, was 4 years, and this was a full-time course, and this was done in India. You need to attach the documents also. And for each qualification, you can upload only one. So you need to consolidate. All right. So I'm going to upload. Okay. So I completed this qualification section. Next is my employment. So let's say this guy, after completing in 2010 graduation, but that's too early, right? 1995 years, John. Okay. Let's say he finished in 2014. All right. Next experience. Let's say after completing his graduation, a month later he joined a company and he has been there for 5 years. So let's proceed. Company name. Let's say New Delhi IT Company. Position. Let's say he was IT engineer. Start date, end date. So let's say he started in 2014, 1st of April. And he's still working. So let's say today, country, India. It has asked for experience document. Again, you need to combine if applicable. And then upload. So I'm going to upload. If you have more experience, you need to click on add experience. And if you have more qualification, you need to click on add qualification and add. So this is the way you proceed. Now click on save and continue. Now you have come to the final page where you review your application, whatever is submitted by you. And then you click on save and continue. You go to the payment page. So here now you have options. You can go either for PayPal if you have a PayPal account or a credit card. The fee here is 500 Australian dollars. You can go back here. You can save this application and you can pay and submit also. So let's say you want to submit using your credit card. Select credit card. So here you need to put your card number, card name, expiry date, CVV. It also gives you the information about where to find the details. So this name, card name, do not confuse it with the card name. It's going to be your name. You can see full name that you can see on your card. CVV, it's going to show you. Expiry date, it shows you. Card number, it shows you. You can see that this screen changes accordingly. Terms and conditions, you need to select agree. On the other hand, if you want to go for PayPal, click on PayPal. Then you, once you click on check PayPal checkout, you're going to log in and then you're going to pay. And again, in this condition also, you need to say click yes, I agree. As I said, you can save, go back. So because this is a sample application, I'm not going to waste my 500 Australian dollars because I've already gone through this process. So, but yes, if you want to go through, you have to pay and proceed. All right, guys. So I hope this was clear and I showed you the steps. Still, if you have any question, any concern, anything, you are welcome to put as a comment. And if you have not already subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and subscribe. And also let me know what exactly you would like to see in the future videos. Thank you guys.